Hi there, welcome back to 3D with Kiwi. Last time we have made a simple light cube rotating around y-axis. Now let's look a little bit deeper and see what you can do with materials. First, we will change the float layout to a grid layout. It'll make the code shorter. Don't forget to initialize it with columns equal to 3. Now let's set the background or environment color of the renderer and make list cubes. Yes, we'll make more than one cube now. And the list will help us keep the track of our objects in the scene. Let's edit our previous cube into a green one. For this, we need to edit the material that is later used to create a mesh. After that, just append the mesh to the list of cubes. Now let's move the cube from the center of the screen to the top right corner and rotate it around x-axis. We'll repeat this piece of code with some changes, but to keep it simple, we'll only copy-paste it. Let's look at more properties of the material you can set. Color is the base color of the object. It's like using a brush in some paint application. Diffuse seems more complicated, but it's quite simple. Imagine a rough stone and light shining on it. The light bounces on the top of the surface in various directions. On our cubes, it may seem like a shadow while it's rotating, therefore the comments about, well, shadows. Specular is mostly described as light shining on a mirror. It reflects the color. There's even transparency of the object, which I think doesn't need an explanation. You'll again move the cube to a desired position and create another two cubes to complete the grid of four cubes with a little bit different materials to see which one does what. Now that we have the cube set, we need to correct the previous method we used for the single cube, change rotate cube to use a for loop. We'll also need to correct scenes add method to add all our cubes. Finally, we'll combine our 3D content with basic cube widget, such as label. And to keep it simple, we'll use the grid layout and empty labels as empty widgets to center the 3D content. After the 3D content, let's add the axis to the labels. Such things may help you better understand where each object is, if you need to change the positions or move the camera. But that's a topic for some other part. Let's run this one. As you may see, grid layout sized the children evenly, but you want to make the 3D content bigger. With this little trick, it won't be necessary to edit each widget size hint to get the desired behavior. Now it looks better. Well, I think that's all for now. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.